Hi, we're Lawson, and this is officialcharts.com.
Our influences as a band are... We have a lot of influences, really. I'd say a big one is John Mayer. We all love John Mayer. The Script, Kings of Leon. Just any playing bands, really, you know, that are out there writing their own stuff and playing, like Maroon 5, One Republic. And also, you know, your solo artists of this day and age, like Adele and Ed Sheeran. I'd say our music's quite like theirs because, you know, we write songs that are real, you know, like it means something to all of us and, like, the album and When She Was Mine, the single, it's just about events that have happened in each of our lives. So I think music like that can really connect with the public, and I think that's the best sort of music out there at the minute. Would you agree, Ryan? Or?
I definitely would agree with what you just said, mate.
Fantastic. Any influences I've missed out? Or?
What would you say personally your influences are, just out of curiosity?
I love the Beatles, personally. But as I said, what I touched on earlier, Script, Kings of Leon. So how about your personal individuality, mate?
Individuality? Yeah. Individually, my influences are, I'd go along the lines of the old rock stuff, Bon Jovi, Guns N' Roses, Aerosmith. I love all that sort of stuff. So what about you, Joel? What do you think?
Me? I'd say, I was saying John Mayer earlier. John Mayer's like my idol. Like, I think he's just the best guitarist, best voice, songwriter, everything. And then I really like the American country scene at the minute. Stuff like Lady Antebellum, Rascal Flatts, Keith Urban, all that sort of stuff.
Awesome.
Yeah. And you, Ad?
For me, again, John Mayer massively, but then Foo Fighters, Paramore, and as a British band, Coldplay as well.
We've got this off to a T. I would describe our style of music, we've thought about this a lot because we get asked it, meaningful guitar-led pop rock, bang.
No,
there it
the
is.
Bang isn't the
yeah, the bang, is, the bang is optional, but that's what we say.
Yeah.
Well, we just sold out our second headline tour so far, which is unbelievable this year, and it's just as the single's coming out as well, we've got the last two dates coming up this week. It's just crazy the fact that we can do that, and fans will come down and buy out all the tickets. It's unbelievable.
Yeah, as Ryan said, it's quite overwhelming, really, because we've only just released When She Was Mine this week, so I think we did our first headline tour in January this year, so even, like, you know, 4 months before the singles comes out, to sell out the tour, and, you know, even places like Glasgow and stuff like that where none of us are anywhere near from, and it's we always get an amazing reaction, so it's amazing.
Yeah, so on this headline tour, we've had a couple of people like storm the stage. It's become quite a thing for the fans. I think they saw a video on YouTube from
Brighton
was the first one, and yeah, everyone just ran up on stage and everything got trodden on.
The fans are trying to like make it their own little new thing now, like, yeah. Whenever they can. If there's no barriers, stage will
give them an opportunity. They're there, so
yeah, it's great. We've been abused. Yeah, we get a lot of pinched asses and stuff like that. But the worst one was like whenever they come around the kit, everyone's just hitting away at the cymbals. Someone found my spare stick, started playing along, and it's
you just see Adam batting away people.
And the thing is, though, sometimes it gets so close, and they're like hanging around by one crash cymbal, and I know that this chorus, I'm gonna have to play that crash cymbal, and I can't warn them that they are gonna get hit in a second. So. They just have to react pretty quickly.